You do whatever you want.
Boy, that's the vision. EJ and Chris, I mean, they're easier to hunt right there.
Yeah.
You know where center is?
Yeah.
And go like so, and you stick it in your pocket.
And how high up is it supposed to be?
Do we just address him?
Now, if...
Now, because Charles is going to take you, you can talk about the cats or whatever.
Back at the warehouse.
Leprechaun.
Leprechaun.
Is that where the cows that are going to have calves will be?
Yes. Yeah.
That's the nursery.
Garfield. He's the yellow cat.
Oh, yeah. Yeah.
Yes?
Oh, yeah, that's a fairly loud beep.
Yeah, and so even when you're downstairs.
Yeah.
And then it turns it on.
Yeah, and it turns it on.
The picture comes on with it, you see.
Mm. Yeah.
And if I'm not here, now the other morning when I went down, he beeped me. I had gone back to sleep again, so he was just for fun calling me.
But does the cow know how to beep it?
Pardon?
Does the cow know how to beep it?
No, the cow doesn't know how. See, it goes off itself, you see?
Oh, yes, oh. Yes.
And I wasn't here, and I was already on my way to the barn.
Yeah. Is he biting at you like Adam?
No.
I've never seen him so tame.
Don't untie my shoelaces. Don't do that. Untie my DJ. This is a very young one too. Friend of Butsy.
Mm-hmm.
Friend of practice getting to heaven. Isn't he?
really trend, Roseanne. These calves, they're not scared at all.
This is the one. That's this one that was lost for 3 days.
Where? Yeah.
From then gone. Terrible girls. Mm-hmm. Out! Cha cha! Come on, outside, boys. Come on. Cha cha.
Ready, we speed up soon?
To
hang on.
And Gracie.
I can't wait till we start speeding up. This is rather slow.
Here we go.
There we go. We're speeding up. We're going. We're going. We're going. We're going.
Nice.
We're going. Oh. And we're leaving everything. Look back, Gracie, look. Look back.
Behind there.
I don't
you see start everything and you see the big hotel and everything.
Look how high we are off the ground.
How high are we?
I'll be fine.
How high are we?
I look our friends passing us over there and say,
somebody
hi.
Coming down.
But there's nobody in them.
There's the hotel down in the distance. And our timeshare unit is to the right
that's
of the
okay.
hotel down
like
over those
so.
Trees.
Okay, can we move out there again though?
This is where we're going up.
All those cyclists.
And all those other cars are coming towards us, and it looks as though we are one of the few people today.
No, I think there are quite a few, but they're probably up there.
Higher and higher we go. Higher
wow.
and higher we go.
My ears just popped.
I have
the horses know that I'm taking the country. They smell. That's the hotel, and our resort is just to the right of that in those trees. And you're going to wonder how I took this picture with me in it, from a distance too, okay? Okay. Too low too, see? Okay.
Is it video camera now?
Yeah. They're all in it.
There it is.
Here's the,
where am I trying to cover?
Oh, you're this? Okay there, yeah. That's, Saint, what is it? De Beaupré? Saint Anne de Beaupré is on there. And that's the island and the river. There's the village of Beaupré itself. Road goes up and up to other little villages in the distance.
I've got a picture of
some people walk them.
They must be terribly energetic.
Or maybe it was part of their day because they were just at the top of their
Village de Beaupré.
And it's just
dung and dung and dung we go.
Flying down.
Where we stop? No.
That's dun, where I can't dun, hear him. Look at go. That.
Where we stop, nobody knows.
No.
See the trees are busy.
And we are nearly there.
It doesn't matter if it's busy. No, it's busy.
And here we arrive at the base. Coming down.
So where do we switch course?
Going where you wait.
Now
we're on slow and we just switch to the slow cable. Everybody gets out. And you're leaving me in here all by myself.
Okay, bye.
Bye. I don't know what that is. Beautiful swimming pool. All the kids are having a great time.
why the work's home has been here in St. Anne of Oldbury. The Jerusalem Cyclorama is considered one of the major works of the 19th century, as much for its imposing dimensions as for its artistic qualities and striking realism. Let's move up to the handrail, at the point indicated by the flashing light. We are standing before the fortified city of Jerusalem, much as one might have observed it almost 2,000 years ago. To bring such minute detail to the achievement of this painting, a team of specialists working under the highly renowned German painter Bruno Bigelheim spent several years of research, including 1 year in Jerusalem. It is due to their work that we are now being given an historically accurate look at the buildings and customs and even the clothing at the time of Christ. According to the artists themselves, this section of the cyclorama illustrates best the excellent artistry of Tool 10 that's been sent out over there. At first glance, yes, but notice how clearly it is detached from the woods in the foreground. Now, look over at the city, and finally, the sky far off, very clear. execution is over, and already the soldiers are beginning their return to the city. Here we discover, once again, the remarkable skill and talent of the artist who produced this work. Even though many of the elements of this painting appear to be in relief, only a few figures seen near opposite Elkhoven, including those in front and the two kneeling soldiers, are actually detached from the work. The creators of this masterpiece clearly surpassed themselves in recreating the spirit and atmosphere of this tragic scene. We invite you to take the time you desire in order to examine and appreciate all the details of this panoramic painting. Viewing glasses are an almost indispensable aid to discovering the perfection and realism of this work. For a very modern... Thank you.
Thank you.
Ferry is coming over from the other side.
Where's the bridge? Oh, I see it. Doesn't matter. Look at Quebec City from the island. What island is this? What island is this? Walking next to the big pipe. Enjoying it, Gracie? Yeah. Oh, you like it? You like it? You like this walk? Yeah.
All right.
So
does Chupri
Chopri.
What's that?
So does my horse. I'm getting back on him now.
An energetic walk through the jungle. Is that right? Skipping and hopping as you go, an energetic walk through the jungle.
I'm definitely
Oh, you're riding a horse?
Trippity-troppity is his name.
Oh, trippity-troppity.
There too. It looks like there's something to see.
having a little rest off. Hi, James.
Hi.
Maybe
he's
Where are we here now, Ames? And what is the name of the place?
No idea.
Yes, you know where we came to get it? St. Simeon.
What?
St. Simeon.
St. Simeon.
And here is our ferryman coming. Ames, are you enjoying yourself?
Yep.
Now, where are you going to go to now? Where are we going to?
We're going across...
to Revere de Loo, right?
An hour trip. I must have a couple.
Look at all the people on that beach. Woo!
Beautiful.
Look at all the birds on that beach. Can I see your flowers? Very pretty. Where do you get those flowers?
Right here. You've got thousands.
Look at them. Thank you. We are leaving port now. Well, that's you, all right. You're traveling. Hi, Gracie.
Hi. It's got a nice
Join the breeze?
Yeah.
All right.
Looks like a jacuzzi down there. Too cold.
There we are, crossing on the boat.
Is that a machine? What kind of have a new machine out there if you just program it? Dang it, goes.
See it, Amy?
Mm-hmm.
Now start driving on
it. No, I don't see it.
There's rock with a hole in it. That's Pierce rock with a hole right through it. This is a rock with a hole in it at Pierce.
Look at the other rock. The one at the very end of it?
Yeah.
There's a cave in it too.
There is? Okay, is that a nice view?
Uh-huh.
All right. Come in, I mean, Grace.
Is still there, but it should be gone because all the pieces. The chairs probably, I don't know, they'd be long gone too, probably.
This is the older picture.
They haven't been around lately, I'm saying that by everyone. Depends on how they. Oh. Yeah. What? Hold on, let's hook there. Can't go up there. You know what? Kat, do you know what you're doing up there?
Not exactly.
Huh?
Not exactly.
Not exactly.
Not exactly.
You know what, I think that whole song, but where's this clip? That's very difficult to do.
And there's the supervisor at the bottom of the ladder. Oh, is he only the ladder tender?
With the pencil.
Oh, with the pencil, huh?
You have the pencil.
Come, Nanny, I want to see you get in the boat.
Huh?
I want to see Nana get in the boat. She's in for everything.
cheetah lot.
You have to jump far.
Guys, are you sure there's a... You are standing right there. You're going to have to leap way out.
Yeah.
You're uncomfortable, don't do it.
I just never looked before.
How's it going?
I heard you were going to the night. I want to see him when you're out.
You're doing good, babe.
Isn't that pretty? Is that green growing every time you have one? Is that green?
What? You're going to go to the island?
Nice. We were coming out to join you, but
and there's Diane in a Canadian lake. You can add this to the Barbadian water pictures.
Still a size 5. As long as they don't stand up, they don't know the difference.
A size 5 plus.
Nanny, that was...
The only hydraulic ram they had was to push it into the tube.
Maybe later.
Put it in the bathroom, you guys.
hope that keeps you awake and doesn't put you to sleep.
What?
I hope that keeps you awake and doesn't put you to sleep going home.
Where are you two ladies going to?
We're going to.
Yeah.
Sorry? Where are you guys going to?
Hiding out.
I was going to see where the hat was.
Well, it's hard to see the hat when it's on you.
He's looking at a hole in the wall.
Abundance of wild blueberry bushes. Huckleberry Island is one of the largest islands in the Parry Sound area. On our port called Dead Island and Skull Island because it is believed that the island was used over 500 years ago as a burial ground for the Ojibwe native villages in the area. It may not look like the island queen can fit through a hole in the wall, but it easily does. The narrowest section channel is 110 feet wide, while the width of the island queen is less than 35 feet. With campers and cottagers in the summer months, it's not uncommon to see numerous tents and boats scattered along the shoreline while their occupants dive from the channel's cliffs, fish for black bass, or simply just walk the shoreline picking blueberries and taking pictures. Another popular spot in the summer months is Kilbear Provincial Park, where the captain of the Island Queen will take the ship next. Thank you.
Hi, Heidi. Heidi. Hello, Heidi.
Can advance my hand.
Hello. Look at your picture up there.
Joe, you're being filmed.
Hey, Joe.
They've already been taken.
Oh, okay.
Hey, Mr. Gale.
Hello, Mr. Gale.
Water Bertha literally invaded the Georgian Bay in the 1980s in search of new sources of fish. Since the initial arrival of the cormorant, fish populations in Georgian Bay have dramatically declined. They feed to a depth of about 100 feet, and cormorants are all black with a long neck and narrow wings. The cottage on the island is one of the first in this area. It was built entirely of log. Throughout the cruise today, you likely noticed green and red buoy markers. When entering a port like Parry Sound, boats are to keep the red markers on their right and green markers on their left. When leaving port, boats do the opposite. Failure to keep the markers on the correct side may result in a boat going over and perhaps hitting a dangerous shoal. entered a very confined area known as Seven Mile Narrows. The channel was blasted out many years ago to allow larger vessels to pass through. Keep an eye on which side of the ship the captain keeps the markers on. I might add that this is an excellent spot for bass and pike fishing.
Oh, you're going to come back, Kelly.
Yeah. Bring the boat. Let's wait just a minute.
Pretty narrow in here.
Oh yeah, look at this. Yeah.
Workboats and barges play a very important role on Georgian Bay in the summer months. Building contractors, gas and oil suppliers, waste disposal companies, and utility firms like Bell Canada and Ontario Hydro all use high-speed workboats and barges to provide services to the islands. Many of these islands are supplied by underwater power and telephone. Open for the birds both in the nest and soaring high in the sky around the hydro pole.
They do have teeth.
This is 2 mile channel, you said. One at a time.
Swimbridge that you see coming up was a railway trestle built by John Hargrove in the late 1800s. And the purpose of the trestle was to extend this Canadian-Atlantic railway to Depot Harbor on the Georgian Bay, so to create a short and direct trade route between the Canadian West and the Atlantic seaboard. The bridge was used for that very purpose until the 1930s, when a series of events left the railway line unused. Now, after the Second World War, the bridge was planked over, allowing cars to travel to the island. The steel to build the bridge was imported from Scotland, while the timbers that you see here on the bridge were cut locally. Now, incredibly enough, the bridge was constructed entirely by hand. Until a few years ago, it was manually operated by a crank in the center of the bridge. Now, recent upgrades and repairs, however, have given the bridge much needed mechanization.
Very good.
Very
very generous, very nice. Yeah. Very nice.
This looks very nice to me. I've got to get this special Heidi salad.
Right.
I can't capture the recipe, but.
You can have the recipe.
Pictures can be taken at any time during the ceremony and the dinner. Was designed and initiated by God Himself. The
very idea of marriage originates from within the heart of God. Therefore, if John and Marianne, or you and I, want a happy and a stable marriage, we must follow the Bible's recommendations and commands for marriage. John and Marianne asked for a special request. That was that Garnet Cooney would come and bring a short devotional message at this time. I'd invite him to come.
It's a real blessing to see so many guests here today. John and Marianne have invited many friends, some of whom I'm not familiar with. There is, however, a special guest who has been invited, of whom I've been asked to speak. To some, he may be unfamiliar. To others, he will have been a lifelong companion. Nearly 2,000 years ago, the Lord Jesus was invited to the wedding of a young couple in Cana of Galilee.
Johnny, will you take Marianne to be your wife? Will you love her as Christ loved the church? Comfort her, honor her, protect her, support her, and provide for her, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her as long as you both shall live. Marianne, will you take Johnny to be your husband? Will you love him, comfort and honor him, submit to his God-given headship, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him as long as you both shall live. John and Marianne have written their own marriage vows, and they're going to say their personal vows to each other at this time.
Marianne, I thank God for you, and praise his name. He has brought us together to complete each other and to be his faithful servants. I believe God has handpicked you for me, and in his perfect will has brought us together to complete each other to be his faithful servants. Therefore, I, Johnny Dean, take thee, Marianne, and thee, be my lawful wedded wife, having to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer, for poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish till death do us part. Marianne, I love you, I adore you, from this day forward, I belong to you.
God's providence, he has given us certain reminding tokens. And following this precedence, Johnny and Marianne have chosen rings. These rings are of the most precious metal, which suggests the most priceless relationship on earth, that of a Christian home. The ring is endless until broken by an outside force, represents the permanence of the marriage union until it is broken by the outside force of death. Johnny, as a ceaseless reminder of this hour and of the value of taken, place this ring, the symbol of your love, on the hand of your bride, and repeat after me. I, John, give you Marianne. This ring as a token of my love. And I pledge you my loyalty and devotion until death separates us. Marianne, as a ceaseless reminder of this hour and of the value of taken, place this ring, the symbol of your love, on the hand of your bridegroom and repeat after me. I, Marianne, give you John. This ring is a token of my love, and I pledge you my loyalty and devotion until death separates us. In the presence of God and before this assembly, John and Marianne have given their consent and have made their vows to each other. They have declared their marriage by the joining of hands and by the giving and receiving of rings. I therefore now with great pleasure pronounce them husband and wife. What God has joined together, let man not separate. You may now kiss your bride. By special request, we're going to ask Daryl Stolz to come and commit the couple to the Lord. Ladies and gentlemen, I would like to present to you Mr. and Mrs. John Coote.
take some pictures.
What starts a computer?
You can have your auto exempt with nothing actually in it.
Yeah. What we can do is I can use it. We'll sit down and we'll discuss how a computer starts up, and then you can see what I mean when you know how a computer starts up from no power to power, and you know the steps it's going to go through. Then you can figure out if it's not getting to this point, then something before that is broken.
I think everybody.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm not picking right now. Is she bailing? Has she bailed it already? I thought I gave you a bailer up there.
Thank you. confirm whether there are any more fatalities in this.
Well, the coroner's down at the scene along with the emergency personnel, and we hope within the next hour to start to remove the vehicles one by one from the fire area, and at that time we'll be able to carefully go through each vehicle and get an exact account on the number of victims.
Is there one area in particular in terms of the whole stretch of vehicles involved where the fatalities are more likely?
Certainly the area that we're talking about, they refer to as a hot spot. That's where there was a rather large fire involving several vehicles. The cluster of vehicles in that area is very dense, and moving out from that, there gets to be less and less vehicles and into some individual accidents in the area.
I heard from the fire official earlier that fire is now out, so I guess that's why.